Hawaii's Kilauea volcano just did something that I, as a volcanologist, could only describe as absolutely spectacular. On Wednesday, at 1:30 p.m. local time on March 26, 2025, for a moment, a lava fountain that towered upwards reached a height of 1,513.5 feet, or 461.3 meters above the erupting dual summit vents. While this height was not sustained for long, it marked the single tallest lava fountain in the entire Hawaiian island chain to form in a whopping 56 years, meaning that this was a once-in-a-generational event. While truly sustained lava fountain heights were a bit lower, for more than 2 hours they remained at a continuous height of 1,000 feet or more. As you might expect from such a spectacle, the observation areas, parking, and general summit area at Hawaii Volcanoes National Park were completely packed, likely marking the park's busiest day in decades. However, those who did manage to find parking might have gotten a bit more than they asked for. While no one was harmed, do note that this eruption of Kilauea is not completely effusive. Instead, as you can see by the brown cloud surrounding the lava fountain and the falling Lapilli seen for a lengthy period of time on the USGS webcams, this eruption is ever so slightly explosive. This has caused large volumes of both Pele's hair to fall and form a dusting in some areas, which is quite sharp by the way, so don't touch it. However, Lapilli, especially during Wednesday's activity, but also including all of the eruptive activity at Kilauea Summit since December 23rd of 2024, has piled up to fairly thick levels, as you can see in these photographs. Because of this, I would just barely assign Kilauea's ongoing eruption a volcanic explosivity index of 01, indicating that more than 10,000 cubic meters of Tephra has been produced. While the relevant falling Lapilli are mostly small fragments, it, the finer grain minor ash particles, and wind-blown Pele's hair are a good enough reason to wear a mask to prevent these particulates from getting into your lungs when viewing a similarly behaving Kilauea eruption. With this being said, why are Kilauea's lava fountains seemingly getting progressively taller during each of its subsequent episodes? While yes, additional volatiles or more silica-rich magma can generate taller lava fountains, in my opinion, something else is to blame here, possibly in addition to both of these two factors. Specifically, that it appears that Kilauea's magma conduits that lead to its two summit vents have seemingly been getting progressively thinner and thinner over time. As a result, magma propelled upwards by the rapid expansion of gas as it rises to the surface propels a smaller amount of magma to a greater height than it would have if a wider magma conduit existed. Such a hypothesis would also explain why eruptive episodes associated with the tallest lava fountains have, for the most part, been notably longer than their counterparts, as, with a few exceptions, each episode is generally erupting about the same volume of basaltic lava. Speaking of eruptive episodes, while Kilauea is still technically undergoing an eruption right now, its current activity doesn't involve continuously tall lava fountains. Instead, it is undergoing predictable cycles which are as follows. At the beginning of each episode, dozens of cycles of weak lava effusion, lava rise and fall in the two summit vents, and small spatter fountains occur via what is known as gas pistoning. This activity gets progressively stronger over time until weak, intermittent lava fountaining becomes stronger, continuous lava fountaining. These lava fountains then progressively increase in height until they reach their peak, ejecting tephra and creating several hundred foot high lava fountains which remain for several hours. Lava fountains then decrease in height until the visible lava effusion ceases, and as a portion of the recently emplaced lava drains back below ground, only weak orange glows are visible occasionally from the summit vents. No lava effusion of any kind occurs during the next step, marking the vast majority of each eruptive episode. The cycle then repeats, with 15 episodes having occurred so far since the onset of this episodic activity on December 23rd of 2024. It is a special time in Hawaii, and I wish everyone luck in hopes of safely viewing a similarly impressive additional lava fountaining episode, which have mostly occurred between 5 and 8 days after the prior one ended. As a final note, I would like to thank this channel's patrons on Patreon and channel members on YouTube.